think we make the films that are like the people we are. I don't think we really have a choice. I don't think I thought, oh, I want to do it in this style. It was like automatic, because I think we're all very different. And I suppose for me, I feel very uncomfortable asking people to do things. So the kind of films that I like to make are where I feel like I'm making them with people, and they're just getting on with their lives and I'm getting on with mine, and we're like two teams working together on one thing, and that's how I feel comfortable. I think my main approach is to make the people in the film feel it's their film as much as mine, in a way more their film, so that they have complete control over their own stories. So in fact, what I'm doing is I'm the person running along beside them, and they're just living their lives and I'm documenting it. And my job is to make it as interesting as possible. It becomes really confusing and very painful, actually. You know the scene in Rafanti's where Studler's little boy gets killed? And then in a way you become quite split. You become two people, because when her boy died, the person that was Kim, that was Studler's friend, was really, really upset and would have just stayed back and let events take their course and not been in this situation so much. But the person that was making the film had to say, I need to film this, you know, that's why I'm here. I'm here as her friend and I do love her, but I'm here to make a film with her. And they could, the rest of the group asked me to be there. They phoned and said, come down, you know, we've had an accident. So they wanted me there. So I knew it was right that I was there. But at the same time, I'm filming this thing and thinking, how can I make sure it cuts in the film? And that made me feel a bit like a monster, because a monster should have just been there with my friend. A person would have been. But this filmmaking person was constructing a film out of it. You know, so it is odd. It's a difficult thing sometimes. The film I made before Dreamcatcher, it's called Salma, and it's not observational at all. And the reason for that is because everything that had happened to her in the past. And so there had to be a way of making her story real for the film now. I couldn't film, there wasn't much going on in her life when I was filming. So I had to somehow reconstruct her past. And that was really through what we were saying. It was through sitting and her telling us things. And then I had to make it into film. So we use a lot of her own voice telling us secrets. So for example, there's a bit where, and I don't know what your families are like, but you know, my family, I had a very strict authoritarian father who in public, like now my friends used would say, oh, your father's really nice. And I think, well, you don't know what happens when everyone's gone, you know. And so there's a scene of her in the kitchen with her mother and they're cooking and it looks really normal. And then her voice, and she says, all I can remember from my childhood is my father being angry and hitting my mother and all the anger and sorrow and my mother being constantly upset. And that's over this very normal scene. And it's about secrets and lies, really. It's about how a family lives on these different levels. So you have these very ordinary scenes and then you have the truth behind the ordinary scenes. And that's how we did it. And I'm sure there's 100 ways of doing it, but that's the way that we did it. Millions of girls this happens to. It's not the law that needs to change, because it's all in place. It's the mindset.